Mi očekujemo iskreno ono što je zaslužio, da se potvrdi presuda koju je dobio I da genocid izbjeći ne može ni po koju cijenu.
The only penalty they deserved is the death penalty, but there is not. And all the things that have happened during the trials, it's big circus. It's not good for the people here. It's not good for us. And there is only one penalty, and that is for life in prison, or I think the death penalty. I never may forget what's happened here on the 11th of July 95.
Ovo je moj Fejzo kad skija na gore na jan.
Svaka druga presuda, ako ne bude doživotna kazna, bit će za nas teško prihvatljiva. Ali ja sam isto svjesna da to se ne pitaju ni majke, ni supruge, nego će biti onako kako politici bude odgovaralo.
Nažalost, u većini slučajeva ratnim zločincima su smanjivane kazne u odnosu na prvostepeni, pa se bojimo da bi takav slučaj mogao biti sa Radovanom Karadzićem, koji zaslužuje ne 40 godina zatvora za zločine koje je organizovao ovdje u Bosni I Hercegovini, nego 400 godina.
Slučaj je tio da baš na dan kada je moja kćerka ubijena 20. marta 1993. godine da bude ovom krvniku, zločincu Radovanu Karadziću izrečena I drugostepena presuda. I u meni se već pojavio jedan nemir, jedna nervoza.
Smatram da Radovana treba osloboditi I da će tako se jedino uspostavljati dijalog I mir na ovim prostorima.
Radovan Karadzic sigurno nije kriv za ono što je mu I u optužnici stoji. To ja znam jer sam sa njim dugo radio. Drugo, on je dobro pripremio svoju odbranu I dobro je napravio svoju žalbu. Tako da sam ja duboki optimista, smatram da će presuda biti u najmanju ruku mnogo, mnogo bolje nego što je sada. Ako bi bilo sreće, ja smatram da bi on trebao biti slobodan čovjek.
It is sensitive, of course, because it challenges the impartiality of the judges, which is the one thing we expect from a judge, right? To be independent, and also, it also impacts how we think about international criminal law and can it ever be impartial?
That picture there, the group picture, we need to do that again. So if we have our commission, we had to meet the needs of the defense and the prosecution. So with Karadzic, he chose 300 cases randomly. We went back to 1,500 families of the missing because we collect at least 3 reference samples per missing persons cases. And in almost 100% of those cases, the families of the missing agreed to provide their genetic data, their private data, to Karadzic himself, which is amazing, and to us demonstrates 100% the desire of families of the missing, not just for closure, because I don't know what closure means in Bosnia or anywhere, but for justice.